mortgage to a house I've never heard of. And what's the deal with Jenny Hill?
Maybe she's a friend.
Maybe she's more than that. My father was a traveling salesman. He could have easily had a second life. A second family.
Stop, that's not real.
What is real with my father? What if all these crazy stories are just a smokescreen so we don't bother looking for the truth?
Okay, I know you want answers, but think about the time we have left. You came here to make peace, Will, not start a war.
War? Did he tell you the war story? Because that's when I first realized he was making it all up.
I'll get the fire started.
Now, I don't like to talk too much about the war. Truth is, I was just another soldier like all the other Alabama boys. But then one night, I intercepted an enemy message.
What'd it say?
Well, that very night at the big USO show, the enemy was planning to kill General Patterson.
How?
A poison blow dart shot by a deadly assassin. Only I could save it.
Were you scared?
Well, a man does what he must. A hero does what no other man can.
Thank you.
Son?
When did this all happen?
During the war.
But which war?
Which war? Don't they teach you anything in school these days?
That's just it, Dad. They do teach us. Well, now I know you did something.
Oh, Bob Way quit, so they're giving me his route. All the way to Dallas.
That's a lot of driving.
Oh, well, hell of a chance to expand my region.
I don't care how far you go, Edward Bloom, as long as you make it back. There is a young child right there, sir.
You got another soccer game this weekend?
It's not soccer season anymore.
Of course not. Look, Will, I'm gonna need you to look after your mother while I'm gone. You're the man of the house while I'm on the road.
On the road to where?
Well, everywhere. How to explain it, Will, is it's not about the destination. The road is something that's in you, a need. You don't drive it, it drives you. You understand?
No.
I've never been a man who lived an office life. I've never been a man behind a desk. I've always been a man who said that staying still is playing dead. The kind who's looking forward to the challenges ahead. People say that's irresponsible. People tell me stay at home. But I'm not made for things like mowing lawns or apron strings. I'm my best when not at rest. So I fight the dragons and I storm the castles and I win a battle or two. Then comes the day it's time I'm packing up and I am bringing all my stories home to you. All I can see is miles ahead with miles to go. Feel this wind and sun and sky. Stop for a coffee, make a friend, and pray the day will never end. Cause there's one more adventure waiting round another bend. Where I fight the dragons and I storm the castles and I win a battle or two. But then a feeling comes like 50,000 drops of banging. Bring my stories.
your son. Then we fight the dragon, set the storm the castles, and I do the best that I can. But everybody knows that's how the story goes. Turn each boy into a bigger man. So I'll fight the till you can.
Different, like something old has joined with something new. What should I do? Do the pills help?
Mostly. They got me floating a bit. Not entirely sure what's real.
Well, I know that feeling. Dad, do you know much about icebergs?
Oh, I saw an iceberg once. They were hauling it down to Texas for drinking water, only they didn't count on an elephant being frozen inside. A woolly kind. A man.
Dad!
What?
I'm trying to make a metaphor here.
And you shouldn't have started with a question, Will, because people want to answer questions. You should have started with the thing about icebergs.
The thing about icebergs is that you only see 10% of them. The other 90% is below the water where you can't see it. And that's what it is with you, Dad. I'm only seeing this little bit that sticks above the surface.
What are you seeing down to? My nose? My chin?
I have no idea who you are, and that is because you have never told me a single fact.
I talk about myself all the time. I tell stories.
Yes, you tell stories, Dad. You make things up. And I'm starting to wonder if it's to conceal something that you don't want other people to know.
Oh, you got me. My secret identity. Superman!
Can we talk about Ashton, Dad?
Ashton, I grew up there. You know that.
So why did we never visit? It's not that far of a drive.
Nothing to see there.
Dad! Dad, I'm about to have a kid of my own here, okay? And it would kill me if he went through his whole life with doubts.
It would kill you, huh? Let's hear it then. What exactly are you accusing me of, Will?
I'm not. I'm just trying to get a handle on something.
Handle as you will. I think we're done.
Dad!
I say get out! Get out, Will!
Will, what did you do?
I didn't do anything.
What happened?
He attacked me! He came after me like I'm a villain!
I'm sure he didn't mean to, Edward. Now let's get you back to bed.
He's got it wrong. I'm not the bad guy.
this man, this tired man. He's a liar and scoundrel to the core.
See this boy, ungrateful boy, knocking on some long forgotten door.
Now I know something he's been hiding, something that his pride will not reveal.
He wastes his time accusing me. What exactly does this fellow feel?
A lifetime Hello.
I wasn't expecting you.
Are you Jenny Hill?
I am. And you're Will. Nice son.
How did you know my father?
From high school. Before that, even.
Were you and my father having an affair?
Wow. You just said it.
I've seen him with women. I flirt. He always has. On some level, I always presumed that he was cheating on my mother. I just never had any proof. This is your signature, right? The deed of this house? You co-signed the loan.
Can I ask you a question? Why'd you come here today? You found this. Why didn't you just ask Eddie?
Because he's dying.
Look, I don't know how much you want to know about any of this. You have one image of your father, and it would be wrong of me to go and change it.
My father talked a lot about things he never did, and I'm sure he did a lot of things that he never talked about. I'm just trying to reconcile the two. You said you went to high school with him. Was that here in Ashton?
It was in Ashton, but Ashton wasn't here. You do know what happened to the town, right?
No.
Oh, honey. That's the only reason why your father came back. See, the state was building a new reservoir. The whole valley was going to be flooded. In just a few hours, the town of Ashton would be 30 feet underwater. Edward Bloom came back to take one last look at the town he left so long ago.
What do we want?
Nothing to change!
When do we want?
Forever!
What do we want?
Nothing to change!
When do we want?
Forever!
As long as we're chained here, the state won't dare drown this town.
Edward Bloom!
It can't be!
It is. Edward, we knew you'd come back. When you left, you said, quote, "I'll never forget Ashton. I'll come back, I promise."
We just thought it'd be sooner.
Edward Bloom. Don Price. That's Mayor Don Price.
Oh, congratulations. Look, I came because I read in the newspaper they're flooding the valley.
Oh, so what's your plan, Edward?
What, you think I'm here to save you?
Well, you're persuasive. You can go talk to him. Get him to stop building the dam.
The dam's already built. The river's rising.
Well, the state's not just going to let us all drown.
Well, yeah.
Well, does anybody even know you're here?
Yeah. Maybe.
Wait. Nobody knows we're here. Edward, you gotta help us. You're the only one that can save this town.
Not this time. Let me tell y'all something. Edward's not a savior. Edward's not a saint. How can he be good for us? He's not the thing he says he ain't. We can change our fate. You bet we can. We don't need this interloping man.
Don's right.
I am not.
I mean, what? You gotta let go of the past.
Start over
now.
Start over
now.
Instead of drown, move the town and start over.
Wow.
You can sweat, you can fret till we're all soaking wet. 'Cause good God, there's a flood on the way. If we start over, tomorrow begins today.
What's so great about these buildings? Nothing. These streets are full of potholes, but these aren't what make a town. A town is made of people and memories and dreams. You got those. You don't need to stay here to stay together.
Where are we gonna move to? We gotta get some new land first.
We couldn't afford to build a new town anyway.
What if I got you the land and the money?
Oh, well, you know where to find us.
Secretive life. Well, I was a mysterious man. After meeting you, I found myself and my wife. All because you told me I can. You're upset, you're in need. I got land and a deed. You can have every weed, every stone. You're the only man who I would ever give a thing to. The truest friend that I've ever known.
Thank you, Amos. Thank you.
No.
Convince me
Jenny, I
He never came back. I guess he never said a word about saving Ashton. The greatest thing he ever did, and I had a story to go with it.
Well, he could have left you out of the story.
No, he could never risk you coming here and finding out. It had to go untold.
It was just a kiss.
You don't understand him, do you?
I want to.
Well, honey, you're the key to all of this. The way Eddie smiled when he talked about you. Well, you were just a boy, but you were smart. He was so proud of you. You knew that, didn't you? He just wanted you to be proud of him, too.
Hello? Hi. What's wrong? What? When? Where is he? Is Mom okay? Okay, I'm coming. I'm sorry.
Is it Eddie?
I don't know.
Is he?
I don't know!
Stop breathing. We call the ambulance.
Is he gonna be okay? I mean, will he get back to the way he was when he... Oh, Mom. I'm so sorry. I should have been there.
There's nothing you could have done.
What does Dr. Bennett say?
Well, they'll know better in the morning. Some tests. I'm supposed to go downstairs and fill out some paperwork.
Okay, I'll go with you.
No, one of us should stay here with him.
I'll go with you.
Dr. Bennett?
Will?
Dr. Bennett, how long have you known my father?
How old are you? Had a couple years to that.
How would you describe him?
5'9", 160, regulated hypertension.
Can he hear us?
It's hard to say what anyone hears. Harder still to know if they're listening.
Ashton, Dad, I know what you did. You saved a town and broke a girl's heart. I get why you didn't want Mom to know. I do. But what you did, it was heroic. I made a list of all your stories. There are 36 basic tales with some variations, of course. Some are just jokes, awful jokes mostly. But you take the rest and it's like a myth. An epic tale about a farmer's son from Alabama who just wanted to see the world. You never did though. I didn't. And I think that's because of you. See, all this time I thought you were trying to impress me. You were just trying to inspire me. And Dad, do you want me to get a nurse? Can I get you something? Can I help? Some water? Dad!
The river. Tell me how it happens.
What happens, Dad?
I go.
What do you mean? You mean what the witch showed you, Dad? I don't know that part of the story. You never told me what you saw. Dad, I don't think I can do this. Okay, I can try. Just tell me how it starts.
Like this.
Okay. First things first. We're in this prison cell. We have to find a way to break out. Find another place to stake out. Look around. Sure we aren't seen. Slowly check the door before we're spotted. Or we're spotted. I know you've been a secret double agent, but we can turn the page into another kind of tale. state of shock. We only need to pick this lock.
Oh, no need.
What's next? Is all anyone needs to begin? What's next has been a friend to you. What's next to do? One word, and then suddenly one more again. Just like that pen writing a perfect tale. Out the door, and pray the coast is clear. Noses to the ground before we're spotted.
We were spotted.
So now we face the ultimate decision. Relinquish our control as we surrender up the fight. Or else we say hello to the collision. Just do our job and do it well.
Or better yet, let's run like hell.
Figured out what's wrong with me. Dropped up and out of the water too long.
Of course. Success is all that anyone needs to begin. What's next has been a friend to you. What's next to do? One word and then suddenly one more again. Just like that pen writing a perfect tale.
Exactly. But I thank you all for coming. A man is as rich as his friends. I am a tycoon. Someone's missing. I was just a child. I met a witch who took a bow and showed me how it ended. I stood here on the shore. The air was sweet and mild. With disbelief implausibly suspended. And in my child's imagination, the way our story's ending.
all sincere.
Thank you.
your granddad, Edward Bloom, helped me catch my first fish. It was this big.
How'd you do it?
Now that is a Bloom family secret, passed only from father to son. Be the hero of the story who can. Be the champion in the fight, not just the man. Thank you.